Recently, I have been hearing a lot about artificial intelligence and machine learning, and I became interested in looking into AI and machine learning a bit more. I sought to get my questions answered. What is artificial intelligence? What is machine learning? And how exactly do they differ? This is going to be an interesting video. Artificial intelligence, or AI, can be simply defined as a branch of computer science dealing with the simulation of intelligent behavior in computers, or the capability of a machine to imitate intelligent human behavior. Both definitions from the Merriam-Webster Online Dictionary. Both these definitions deal with the concept of computers being able to go about doing complex tasks by themselves, and in this case we aren't speaking of simple processes, we're speaking of the ability of a machine to act completely on its own without the need of human intervention. Well, after being created of course. We can see examples of this in many places, but the most common is in movies. Movies such as Wall-E. You can consider Wall-E an AI robot. He thinks for himself, does what he needs to do for himself, and has something that resembles a conscience. We can actually see this in a majority of Disney and Pixar movies where inanimate objects come to life and make decisions of their own. It's pretty interesting. Upon doing my research, I came across a very interesting article which proceeds to give a bit more information on the history of AI. Here's a short extract from Bernard Ma, a writer at Forbes. Artificial intelligence has been around for a long time. The great myths contain stories of mechanical men designed to mimic our own behavior. Very early European computers were conceived as logical machines, and by reproducing capabilities such as basic arithmetic and memory, engineers saw their job fundamentally as attempting to create mechanical brains. As technology and importantly our understanding of how our minds work has progressed, our concept of what constitutes AI has changed. Rather than increasingly complex calculations, work in the field of AI concentrated on mimicking human decision-making processes and carrying out tasks in ever more human ways. Now, I personally don't like the idea of us humans attempting to create machines which can think for themselves, mainly because I don't see it going anywhere positively. I'm not going to go in depth, but it's not a good idea to me. Things can go wrong in so many ways. And someone else who has a big impact in the field of technology and automation feels the very same way. Elon Musk. The giant who has led Tesla to where it is today in not only vehicle automation, but also in the creation of many clean energy stations around the world. But something interesting that he said caught my attention. This was back in 2017, and not only did it get my attention, but it got the attention of many tech enthusiasts out there. Elon Musk referred to the dangers associated with the development of AI as possibly a bigger threat than North Korea. And we're talking about a nation which has, at their hands, the power to launch a barrage of nuclear missiles at America and possibly start another world war. This is a quote from an article from CNBC. Tesla CEO Elon Musk fired off a new and ominous warning on Friday about artificial intelligence, suggesting the emerging technology poses an even greater risk to the world than a nuclear conflagration with North Korea. Musk, a fierce and long-time critic of AI, once likened it to summoning a demon in a horror movie, said in a Twitter post that people should be more concerned about the rise of machines than they are, reacting to the news that autonomous tech had bested competitive players in an electronic sports competition. Musk posted what appeared to be a photo of a poster bearing the chilling words, "In the end, the machines will win." Musk, who is spearheading commercial space travel with his venture SpaceX, is also the founder of OpenAI, a non-profit that promotes the safe development of AI. His stance puts him at odds with much of the tech industry, but echoes remarks of prominent voices like Stephen Hawking, who has also issued dire warnings about machine learning. End of quote. Now this is indeed interesting, because it shows that not everyone is on the side of developing AI, because in the end we never really know what is going to happen, and from how it's being described to us, it's not really looking that safe. obscure tests seem to be okay, but when scientists attempt to get this out and connect AI beings to the internet and actually get them out there, I think it's going to be a good time to watch your back. Now, let's speak a bit more about machine learning. According to Wired, machine learning is defined as the science of getting computers to act without being explicitly programmed. They got this definition from the University of Stanford, and while I get the idea of the concept, there's sort of a crossover with the definitions and understanding of artificial intelligence and machine learning. Again, quoted from Wired. Big technology players such as Google and Nvidia are currently working on developing this machine learning, desperately pushing computers to learn the way a human would in order to progress what many are calling the next revolution in technology: machines that think like humans. Over the past decade, machine learning has given us self-driving cars, practical speech recognition, effective web search, and a vastly improved understanding of the human genome. End of quote. Now, I should state that machine learning is sort of a subcategory underneath AI. Back to the Forbes article, machine learning is a current application of AI based around the idea that we should really just be able to give machines access to data and let them learn for themselves. A typical example is Google's autofill. When you make a typo, for instance, while searching in Google, it gives you the message, "Did you mean ... question mark?" This is the result of one of Google's machine learning algorithms, a system that detects what searches you make a couple seconds after making a certain search. So if you search for one thing, misspell it, realize you made the error and correct that, Google learns from that mistake. Google's algorithm recognizes that you search for something a couple of seconds after searching for something else, and it keeps this in mind for future users who make a similar typing error. As a result, Google learns to autocorrect for you. That's machine learning in its simplest form. We've just spoken about AI and machine learning. But another interesting thing which I came across in my research is the term deep learning. Something very interesting. According to Callum McClelland of Medium.com, deep learning is one of many approaches to machine learning. Deep learning was inspired by the structure and function of the brain, namely the interconnecting of many neurons. Artificial neural networks, or ANNs, are basically algorithms that mimic the biological structure of our brain. In ANNs, there are neurons which have discrete layers and connections to other neurons. Each layer picks out a specific feature to learn, such as curves or edges in image recognition. It's this layering that gives deep learning its name. Depth is created by using multiple layers as opposed to a single layer. End of quote. So as the name implies, deep learning can be understood to be something that allows a system to analyze and go in depth with the data that it is receiving, adding more and more layers when more information is gained. I think Nvidia puts these terms correctly and gives a better understanding of what machine learning and deep learning mean. Machine learning at its most basic is a practice of using algorithms to parse data, learn from it, and then make a determination or prediction about something in the world. So rather than hand-coding software routines with a specific set of instructions to accomplish a particular task, the machine is trained using large amounts of data and algorithms that give it the ability to learn how to perform this task. For deep learning, neural networks are inspired by our understanding of the biology of our brains, all those interconnections between the neurons. But unlike a biological brain where any neuron can connect to any other neuron within a certain physical distance, these artificial neural networks have discrete connections and directions of data propagation. You might, for example, take an image, chop it up into a bunch of tiles that are inputted into the first layer of the neural network. The first layer, individual neurons, then passes the data to a second layer. The second layer of neurons does its task, and so on until the final layer and the final output is produced. Each neuron assigns a weighting to its input, how correct or incorrect it is relative to the task being performed, and final output is then determined by the total of those weightings. We can see AI encompasses many things, and there are so many other things that I could talk about, but I've mostly achieved my purpose in this video. So thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, learned anything new, or want more, feel free to subscribe, comment your thoughts below and leave a like. I also recommend that you check out previous videos using the links provided in the description below or on screen. I hope you learned something new from this video, and with that, I will be seeing you in the next one.